Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about Infiniti's new VCT engine, Variable Compression Turbocharged Engine. Now I personally think they should have called it Variable Compression Ratio and made VCRs great again, but that's besides the point and not my decision to make. So the reason why this engine has gotten so much media hype lately is because what it's doing is trying to remove compromise from engines. So traditionally you can have an engine that's really powerful, but it won't be very efficient, or you can have an engine that's very efficient, but it won't be very powerful. And so what Infiniti's trying to do here is allow you to choose between both of those options with the same engine. You're not gonna have both at the same time, but you can choose to run it efficiently, or you can choose to run it with a lot of power, depending on where your foot is on that gas pedal. And so the way they do this is by incorporating this variable compression ratio. It can be as low as 8:1 with lots of boost for high power, or it can be as high as 14:1 for a very efficient operating condition. And so how does this system work? How does it do this? Well, it looks like this complex mess, which it kind of is, but we're gonna break this down simply so that we can understand what's going on. And so the way I wanna do this is look at this in two different sections. This top section here, which is just gonna be like a normal engine, and then this lower section here, which is going to be used to adjust the compression ratio. So for now, let's just ignore everything below this and look at what we've got going on up top. So here we have our piston, the connecting rod, the cylinder, everything like usual. The difference here is this crankshaft. So you can see there's this rectangular piece called the multi-link, and that's going to be linking up these two sections. And so your crankshaft is going to be right here, the center of rotation right there. So to give you an understanding of what this looks like, here we have a crankshaft. And so this right here is this right here. And then the center, this axis which it rotates about, is of course right there. So looking at this, this crankshaft right here, how this would be oriented would be just like that, with the center right here, and then this will rotate around. This piston will come down and up, and rotate this section. Now the important thing that you need to understand is that this multi-link piece right here, this rectangular piece, maintains this orientation as it goes around the crankshaft. It doesn't rotate, it maintains that orientation. And so that's what we're gonna be using to change the compression ratio, is changing the angle of this rectangular piece right here. So you can see if you were to tilt it up, that would cause this piston to move up, increasing the compression ratio. And if you were to tilt it down, that would decrease the compression ratio, pulling the piston down. So what we're looking at right here is top dead center, the crankshaft oriented like that. So you've got the top of it right here, and then the center of it right there, and it's about to rotate down like that. So how this works on the compression ratio adjustment system, basically all you need to know about this side of the system, the most important piece, is that what you're trying to do is to move this lower link up and down, because as you move this lower link up and down, you change the orientation of this rectangular piece, this multi-link. And so if you were to pull it down, you can see you'd increase the compression ratio because it pivots about this point, pushes the piston up. And if you were to push it up, you would pull the piston down, decreasing the compression ratio at top dead center. Okay, great. So how does it do this? Well, the magic of it really comes down to this central shaft right here, but basically we have a harmonic drive right here. You can just think of this as a device which rotates clockwise or counterclockwise. And then you have this actuator arm which rotates this central shaft. So the central shaft rotates about this pivot point right here. So you can see if this central shaft were to rotate downward, if it were to rotate down that direction, it's going to pull this lower link down, and by pulling that lower link down, it's pushing the piston up, increasing the compression ratio. If it were to rotate upward, if this piece were to rotate up like that, it's going to push up on here, and then that's going to pull this down, and that's going to decrease your compression ratio. So it's all dependent on which way you turn this actuator arm. It's linked up, and it's going to cause this to pivot about this point right here. So you can see currently this is the state it's in. If you were to rotate it using this linkage, you could rotate it down and you would increase your compression ratio to 14:1, or you could turn it all the way up and that would push this up, pivot this down, and that would decrease your compression ratio down to 8:1. So, you know, once you kind of see all of this work together, it's really not that complicated, but it is kind of a mess looking at all of it together. And so the important thing to just kind of see is that it can rotate, this rectangular piece rotates around the crankshaft, about this point right here, and then these two pieces right here, these two links, keep this rectangular piece in that orientation as it goes around, and you can change that by changing the height of this lower link using that central shaft. Great, that's all clear, right? And so, you know, why do you want to do this? Well, as I mentioned, you kind of remove that compromise. So you can use a low compression ratio, you can put in tons of boost. And so why do you need a low compression ratio? Well, you want to prevent knock. And so, you know, you start to get into some tricky scenarios if you have high compression ratio and high boost. So to make it safe, reliable, you decrease the compression ratio, and then you eliminate, you know, your reduce your chances of knock, and you have a safer running, more powerful engine. Well, then you can pump it up to that 14 to 1, get that really high efficiency. Not only does 14 to 1 have a higher thermal efficiency, but they've used this in combination with the Atkinson cycle. So they're using variable valve timing to leave those intake valves open for a short duration during that compression stroke. And that improves the efficiency. I have a whole nother video explaining how that Atkinson cycle works if you're interested. But basically what they're doing is giving you really good efficiency in one operating condition and lots of power in the other operating condition. So is it going to be the most efficient 2-liter engine out there? Well, no, of course not. And is it going to be the most powerful 2-liter engine out there? No, but what it's doing is it's allowing you to choose between both of those. So if you're cruising down the highway, you can get great fuel economy. And then if you're ripping through, you know, a canyon, you can actually have some fun. It'll decrease the compression ratio, load it up with boost, and you've got all kinds of power. So it is a very cool option to give you efficiency when you want it and power when you don't. So thank you guys for watching. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below.